Good morning, children. In the previous video, we studied about how the constituents affects the earth. There are two types of disasters, natural and human. Earthquake, tsunami, cyclone, floods, these are examples of natural disasters. When there is an earthquake, its effects can reach far. For example, we saw in March 2011, a very severe earthquake took place in northeastern Japan. It was so severe that it was felt in Russia and in China too. Do you remember I told you TSU means harbor and NAMI means wave, that is tsunami. The earthquake and tsunami caused major damage in Japan. Thousands of people died and thousands were injured and homeless. Not only Japan, but islands in the Pacific Ocean, then the west coast of North America and even the coast of Antarctica was affected. Water, land, and living things were all affected by this natural disaster. Then we saw an example of man-made disaster. Sometimes human actions affects our environments. Some effects are for a shorter period and some are for a longer period of time. Here we saw that how the oil was leaked from the tanker and the sea was stained black with the oil. The oil traveled with the waves. It reached the land and the coast was black. Coast were blackened with the oil. Water birds or water animals in the sea got covered with black sticky oil and were unable to use their wings. Many of the birds died. This was due to human action and it affected the water, land and the sea creatures. Hence, it affected the constituents of our earth. Today we are going to talk about science, people and the environment. Look at these pictures, children. Medical science has made tremendous improvement through new medicines, better hospitals, so better treatment. Even we have studied in the previous chapter how petrol, diesel, kerosene is produced from crude oil or petroleum and it is used to generate power. The cars, trains, airplanes, lifts for high buildings, machines used in homes like the washing machine, dishwashers, grinding machines. This is all scientific developments. We will study about the impact on people due to advanced technology and scientific development. Look at these pictures, children. Yes, it's a very big hospital and this is a huge industry. Now, children, people get high standard medical treatment to live long. For an example, earlier, before the 19th century, there was no treatment for cancer. People used to die. But today, we see there is treatment for cancer. Hospitals treat the patient by giving radiation and chemotherapy. And a person's life is extended. This is how the population of the world has grown as people live healthier and longer. If we talk about the industries, earlier people did not have air conditioners, washing machines, fridge, cars, but now you get all these things. People's lives have become comfortable. You know, children, at the beginning of the 19th century, the world's population was about 790 million. Now it is over 7 billion. Researchers say that if we continue to use the Earth's resources like this, then by the year 2030, we will need two earths to provide what we need. Nowadays, use of vehicles have increased, causing pollution. Instead of cars and bikes, bicycles should be used because bicycles are a clean way to travel since they do not use fossil fuels. Now, there is an impact on the environment too. Natural resources do not increase. The resources have to be shared by more people. Due to the increasing population, the fossil fuels are being reduced rapidly. We have also seen that water, soil, and air are all being affected in different ways because of human actions. If you talk about global warming, children, we burn the fossil fuels which produces carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. This gas do not allow heat to escape from the atmosphere. So the world is becoming hotter and hotter day by day. The ice in the polar regions is melting. And what happens to this melted ice? It meets the sea. This increases the sea level. As the water in the sea increases, the coastal regions and the islands will go under water. You must have noticed that the weather is changing. In summer it is very hot and winter is much colder with heavy snowfall. Sometimes there is no rain, and if it rains, it causes floods. Plants, animals and people are in danger. Look at these pictures. This is the windmill and these are the solar panels. The sun and the wind can produce clean energy. They do not pollute the environment. But it is very expensive. So very small amount of energy is produced. In India, we have such plants, but not too many. But sometimes, if an accident takes place, it can damage plants, animals, and people. Children, the chapter ends here. I hope you all have understood the lesson. Read the chapter thoroughly and go through the video. For the homework, you will do the exercises on page 115 and 116. Only do question B and question D. All right. Till then, you all take care. Bye.